Everyone, this is Omori Kira. Welcome to the second part of my live 2D and Facebook tutorial series. Yay! Please don't forget to read the description for links to resources and timestamps of this video. If you find this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to me so you would know when the next part will be out. I also have some announcements at the end of the video, so please keep on watching. Let's start! For this video, I will be introducing you to Live2D's deformers and parameters. These will help us in defining the model's movements, such as head turning, mouth movements, etc. Please note that I will be very specific when it comes to the steps in this video, since there isn't a single way to define your model's movement. Your model is your own, and you can be as liberal as you want when you are defining your model's movements. So let's go to Live2D. Okay, let's start talking about deformers first. There are two types of deformers in Live2D. The curved deformer, this one, and the rotation deformer. The curved deformer is a rectangular deformer with a Bezier. Did I say it right? The Bezier curve grid. You can use this deformer when you want to make a rough deformation for a whole part. Let me demonstrate. You can create a curved deformer by clicking this button and select the part where you want to deform. Let's say the head. Edit the name here. And then we can select a parent here, but generally it's better to not select anything first before creating your deformer. The head, then create. And for this one, for example, we want the head base to be under this deformer. We just select the head base and then select its deformer right here. There. Or when you are viewing it here, you can just drag the head base to whatever deformer you want it to belong to. Let's delete this deformer because we don't need that. Okay. Make sure that you scale and place your deformer correctly, or you will end up like me. I misplaced a deformer. Let me show you. See, it's so stupid. Okay, now let us talk about rotation deformers. Using a rotation deformer will help you rotate an object, set the pivot point, and edit its angle. You can use this deformer for head rotation and arm movements. Okay, now let us talk about parent and child hierarchy for deformers. A child deformer is the object or objects inside of your deformer, and a parent deformer is what encloses the objects for deformation. Be mindful when it comes to assigning parent and child deformers. This was actually the one thing that I had most difficulty with when I was creating my model. Like, I was trying to set parameters for head rotation, but every time I rotate the head, the eyes aren't just right, like the iris positions are just everywhere. I recommend referencing sample light 2D models for this issue. Studying sample models has been really helpful for me. And now I'll be showing you the hierarchy of my deformers. You can just pause the video or play the video at a slower speed if you cannot catch up. I'll actually zoom in. Let me open everything first so you can see each deformer and the objects under them. There. I'll just move slowly. These are fairly easy to understand because I tried my best to properly name everything. As you can see, you can have several deformers under each other. There. Let's go back to the original window scale. Now, let's talk about motion parameters. With motion parameters, you can assign movements of your model at a given point on the parameter. These points are called keyframes. You use parameters in conjunction with your deformers. You can use the default parameters of base rig, but you aren't limited to them. You can create new parameters by pressing this button. I also recommend creating folders for your parameters so you wouldn't be scrolling up and down all the time. You can create a new folder by clicking this button or just right-clicking a folder and selecting Create Folder. You can rename a folder by double-clicking the name and editing it. And to open your folder, just double-click the folder. Okay. You can quickly select keyforms by right-clicking them. Also, deformers can be pretty limiting for specific applications, so you can also set parameters for the objects themselves. Remember that we had set a mesh here? You can click a keyform and then modify your object by modifying the mesh, and Live2D automatically detects any changes. So now we will be setting motion parameters. Once you have selected your object, let's say an eye wipe, move here, and go to the parameter where you need some changes. For example, the eye open stuff, the eye blinking parameter. You can click this button right here to produce 3 keyforms and this one for 2. You can also add custom keyforms. Double click the parameter and click this button here with the green dot. And then assign a value for the position of the keyform. You can also assign multiple parameters to an object. Just select the parameters you want with your desired object or deformer selected and press these buttons here. Always make sure that you are selecting the correct objects, and always be careful. And always be careful when setting parameters. You might accidentally set parameters for a drawable object or deformer. You can check the parameters assigned to an object or deformer by selecting your object and then going through all of the parameters. You can see that it has parameters set if the keyframes are green. If you see that there is a parameter that shouldn't have been there, you can click this button right here to delete all keyframes. Okay, now once you have selected your object, let's say this one. Just go to the keyform you want and then modify your object. You would also notice that there are linked parameters like this. You can link parameters by clicking this button right here. And there you have it. You don't need to worry about the corners because you can automatically generate them. So just modify your model on these keyframes, the cross, and after you have done that, select your parameter, click this button, and then synthesize corners. After that, you can go to those keyframes and make some little adjustments just in case you do not like what you see. Now, I'll be demoing my parameters for you. You can slow down the playback speed of this video if you want to take a closer look. Okay, so I'll give you some notes and tips. Guide sketches are always helpful, especially for the head angle parameter setting. You can sketch different head angles as additional layers on your model PSD and re-import the PSD to Live 2D. Live 2D will automatically detect that there is something new in your PSD and add the additional layers as new objects. Make sure that the draw order of your guide sketch is high, so it'll be above everything. You can also change the opacity of your guide sketch. Okay, select your object or your guide sketch. You can change the draw order here and the opacity here. When you have your guide sketches, deform and modify your drawable objects to fit your sketch. You could also use head angle images found online. Just make sure that they have transparent backgrounds. And for some reason, District only detects these points for mouth movement, not much of the other ones. I still have to study other live 2D models that I can find on FaceRig for better mouth movements. That is it for this video. I hope you found this helpful, and don't be afraid to experiment with stuff, because that's how you learn. If you have any questions or comments, don't hesitate to comment down below. I'll make sure to read them and respond to your comments. If you like the content I'm making, please consider subscribing to my channel and be a part of the Peach Pies. For my old viewers, I know that I have set a streaming schedule and I'm currently on a break right now since I feel like I couldn't really stream efficiently because my laptop isn't really the best. I'm still waiting for the right time to upgrade my laptop so I can stream again. Okay, I don't think I'll be streaming on YouTube anymore because the last time I streamed here, the delay was just too big. Yeah. I'll be uploading part 3 of this tutorial series soon. I hope next week. Yeah. So please wait until then. So I'll see you next time. So see ya, Kira.